in service now. So can we have complete quiet across the church? Just take a couple of seconds of reflection before we start.
Shouting in the desert, "Get the road ready for the Lord. Make a straight path for him to travel. Every valley must be filled up, every hill and mountain leveled off. The winding roads must be made straight and the rough paths made smooth. The whole world will see the Lord coming."
Thank you. great light. Those who live in a dark land, the light will shine on them. There is a young woman who is going to have a baby. She will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Then all the people who have lived in the dark will walk out into the light. The baby to be born will be our king. He'll be as wise as Solomon and as strong as God. He'll be called the Prince of Peace.
Emmanuel, God with us, we pray that we can be more thoughtful of others and put people before ourselves. May we remember the true meaning of Christmas is the special birth of Jesus, not the presents under the tree. We also pray that we can spend more time with our family and be more loving towards them. Christmas is a family time, a time to celebrate. Fill our hearts with hope of our Lord Emmanuel.
Thank you.
messenger to town called Nazareth to a girl called Mary, who was engaged to a man called Joseph. The messenger said, "Rejoice, Mary, for the Lord has blessed you, and he is with you now. Do not be afraid. God is very pleased with you. Listen, you are going to have a baby, and you will call him Jesus." Then Mary said, "I am the servant of God, and I am glad to do whatever he wants."
Emmanuel, God with us, we pray asking you for help. With all our challenges in our lives, let us use the example of Mary, mother of Jesus, and the hardship that she went through when she was told that she would be blessed with being the mother of Jesus. Let her and God, our Father, guide us through our challenges and our lives that we may face. Fill our hearts with the faith of our Lord Emmanuel.
Young and carefree, angel Gabriel came to me, and by his speaking I was troubled deeply. And as I looked into his eyes, a voice spoke deep inside of me. Heed these words of wisdom, let it be.
had to obey the emperor's order.
Emmanuel, God with us, pray. Help us to remember those who sleep unfed, those who are strangers in foreign lands, those who have traumatic experiences, those who are marginalized, those who are fleeing conflict. Help us to remember them. Fill our hearts with the courage of our Lord, Emmanuel.
Thank you.
him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them at the inn.
Emmanuel, God with us, we pray for all the newborn babies in our school community and around the world. We give thanks for the midwives, nurses and doctors who take care of them at the start of their lives. May those who protect them as they grow be guided in your love in their roles as parents and carers. Fill our hearts with the love of our Lord Emmanuel.
Thank you.
pray that you bring us the peace and joy we seek in life. Fill our hearts with the glory of our Lord Emmanuel. The shepherds didn't waste a minute and hurried to Bethlehem. They quickly found the stable and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. They told them everything they had heard. Mary listened carefully to their story, and she kept all these things in her mind.
That you help us spread the good news of your birth with all our hearts.
and in everything we do. As it said in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32, be kind and compassionate to one another. Fill our hearts with the joy of our Lord Emmanuel.
Thank you.
some wise men came from the east to King Herod in Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We have seen his star rising in the east, and we want to honor him."
Emmanuel, God with us, we pray, please protect us on the journey we're about to take into the new year. Support us with your strength and grace when we're weary. Hold us in your loving hands throughout the way, and let us feed on your glory, just like when baby Jesus was in the Virgin Mary's womb, waiting to be born, traveling to Bethlehem. Watch over us like you did to Mary. For all we need your blessings. Fill our hearts with the spirit of our Lord Emmanuel.
Thank you. hearts are filled with cheer. Families and friends all draw near. The streets around are all filled despite the cold winter chill.
Everywhere there's smiling faces, giving and receiving warm embraces. And for a time, sadness disappeared. Peace, love, joy, hope replaces fear. All because God's love came down and filled the earth all around. So we celebrate at Christmas time, our Saviour and Lord, Holy Divine.
We honour Jesus throughout the year, so the Christmas spirit will linger near. For the story of his birth is ours to tell, that Jesus became our Emmanuel.
Emmanuel, God with us, we pray that there may be peace in all regions of the earth. Grant everyone peace, love, and understanding. Please heal and remove everything that has caused grief and sorrow in our lives. Where there is hatred, let love grow. Where there is despair, let there be hope. Fill our hearts with the peace of our Lord Emmanuel.
Oh, and white, our heavenly home. Make safe the way that leads on high, and close the path to misery.
So it was,
into this world was born the baby who was to change the world.
God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, so that anyone who believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Thank you. Christmas begins. When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with the flocks, then the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal those broken in spirit, to feed the hungry, to release the oppressed, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among all peoples, to make a little music with the heart, and to radiate the light of Christ every day in every way, in all that we do, in all that we say. Then the work of Christmas begins.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Emmanuel, today we give you thanks for your presence in our midst. Teach us to offer you hope, announce your peace, share your joy, and receive your newborn love. O God, let your face shine on us so that we may light the way for others. Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence as Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Go in peace then to love and serve the Lord. And may you have the gladness of Christmas, which is joy. May you have the faith of Christmas, which is hope. May you have the spirit of Christmas, which is peace. May you have the heart of Christmas, which is love. And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and our Lord Emmanuel and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen. May we please sit. May I have the privilege to invite all of us to clap and raise applause for our children and teachers, please. Children who have sung so well, to say thank you to the teachers who have put in so much time and effort in preparing them, and to thank you parents for all the sacrifices, especially those of you who have been standing for the past almost 1 hour. Children, can we clap for our teachers and parents? the meaning of Christmas. The preparations, as the word of God says, prepare a way for the Lord. The singing, as the angels sang Hosanna on the night of his birth. And the joy, as the whole world rejoiced at the birth of our Savior. And finally, we all depart with a cheerful heart and share the joy and the happiness of Christmas with everyone. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Good evening, everybody. I promise to those of you who are standing, I'm going to be brief because I know you've been stood there for a long time. Children who have formed the beautiful tableau, I know some of you are kneeling, so if you do want to just sit on the floor, and girls at the back, if you want to sit on the floor, just for the next couple of minutes, otherwise you'll get tired legs. Now, there isn't too much more for me to say, really, after Father Patrick so eloquently thanked everybody. Children, really, I suppose, from me, I want to tell you that I speak for every adult in this room when I say we are immensely proud of every single one of you. This evening, each of your presentations have so beautifully told this wonderful Christmas story. And I know that it was an opportunity for you to showcase some of your many, many talents that you are growing and developing every single day. So children, well done. Let's give them another round of applause. To quote a wise woman, no Yahoo. Thank you. And to the adults and all the families who have joined us this evening, it is truly wonderful to see you. I can't remember the last carol service we've had that has been this well attended. It's really wonderful that you've joined in this celebration with us this evening. Please don't let that joining in the celebrating end there. On Christmas Eve at 4 p.m, there is a special children's mass here at St. Elphege's Church. The children partake in lots of the singing and the readings throughout, and it would be really, really wonderful if you could join us at that mass. The children will know the songs, and it's a really joyous occasion where we can be together as part of our St. Elphege's family. It doesn't matter if you're not Catholic, everybody is most welcome. Please do come along. We'd love to see you. Finally, I'd like to say a couple of thank yous. Thank you, obviously, to Mrs. Wildman and to Mrs. Russell. Now, I know what it feels like to be on the other side of that piano, shuffling music, letting it blow away in the breeze, and having some dagger looks from the conductor every now and then. It's not terribly easy. Mrs. Wildman, thank you very much. I'm sure you'll be worn out. Mrs. Russell works exceptionally hard to support all of our staff in putting together the presentations for the carol service. I promise you, she'll be starting next year's tomorrow. That's how much work goes into the carol service preparation. I'd like to thank all of the staff, not just for all of your hard work this evening in putting the presentations together so beautifully with your children, but actually for all of your hard work every single day. The commitment and dedication you show to our children and families and our schools is truly quite remarkable. We really do appreciate it, and I know the families with us this evening and the children do too, so thank you. Finally, I'd like to say a thank you to Father Patrick and to Father Emmanuel, who are wonderful friends of our schools, who are both here this evening because they love our schools and they want to celebrate with us this wonderful time of year as we think about that Christmas story with our children. Thank you, Father Patrick and Father Emmanuel. Now, we get to the part about the money. As you leave this evening, we will be having a collection. Our collection is for our Federation Faith Fund. For those of you who don't know, our Faith Fund is a fund that we hold within the school that we use to support families within our community. And that might be for a whole variety of reasons, because from time to time people experience crisis in their lives. And I know more than ever, money's tight for people. And one of the remarkable things about St. Elphege's is the sense of community that we really nurture and embrace every single day. And I suppose it's an embodiment of what we're about and what we do at St. Elphege's. We look after each other. That said, I understand money's tight. Please don't feel compelled to donate if you cannot afford to. But if you can, just know that money goes to very worthy causes within our own community. All I suppose that is left for me to say is that I wish you all, everybody, the children, the staff, the families, Father Patrick, Father Emmanuel, I wish you all a very, very happy and holy Christmas. Children, please be good, otherwise there will be no presents. Do not drive your parents mad. And I understand, Mrs. Russell, there is one final song that the children may be able to send that message much better than I am. Okay.
Just before we sing that song, I think there's one final thank you without any screaming or yahooing, as we call it. And that goes to Mr. Jones, because it's been quite a turbulent term. There's been a lot of change, obviously, with Mrs. Hawkes leaving, Mr. Jones taking on the executive head teacher's role. I just want to say a really big thank you to you. Thank you for steadying the ship, as it were, and building stability for us. So thank you very much, and we wish you a very, very Merry Christmas as well. So we have a round of applause. Thank you very much, everybody. Children, if you would sit down. Parents, we're not just going to release the children out into the wild. I would ask you to come and speak to the teacher and collect them from where they are seated, please. Thank you very, very much, children. Make sure you tell your teacher before you go. Thank you, everybody.